Hey, welcome back. You may be wondering what this Arduino board with a shield, this giant chunk of steel, and this old steel pallet have in common. Well, they're about to become my dyno. So first up, we have the Arduino Shield. Two-stroke stuffing was selling these. I picked this up about a year ago. I was looking for a large electric motor to make one out of, and was just coming up kind of short. I couldn't find anything. I don't know if he's still selling these boards or not, and the back is just an Arduino. But this is where I got mine from. He may still have some for sale. He may be making another batch. I'm not sure. You'd have to bug him. But it's basically a Arduino-based dyno software. It has an RPM pickup. And you can also input vehicle RPM. It also has a bunch of inputs along this side. You can input other values, and then the Arduino will scale that information into your graph. It's a pretty neat, for basically free, it's a pretty neat piece of kit. Definitely check them out. You probably already are if you're watching me. Then next up, we have these two beauties. So this is a giant hunk of steel. It is mild steel of some sort with a mild steel piece of shaft, and these are bearings out of a blower system, like a ventilation system, just all repurposed stuff. Trying to make this as cheaply as possible. And lastly, I have this, which is a old pallet from a CNC machine that my buddy's shop got. Yeah, just a big, heavy tubing pallet. So that's going to be the frame for the dyno, and I'm going to build up around it. Hopefully you'll have the basics of the frame done tonight, and with the uprights, and then tomorrow maybe I'll go get some sheeting and finish this thing up. So I think it's time to just jump into this and start. So instead of boring you with a bunch of stuff of me welding and cutting and, you know, sped up scenes, let's just cut to the actual cool stuff of this thing actually being built. So the frame, all this lower frame, is an old pallet from a CNC machine. Just got it from my buddy, and it actually made almost the entire base. The only material I actually had to buy was this 1x1. So then this decking is just some scrap metal that we saved from the dumpster from my local place. And this is a piece of that pallet cut in half, made into L-bracket. And then the wheel chock, which is just sliding and then has bolt holes, the pins that go in to hold it. Is the braces off of a CNC router table that picked up last week or so. And then on the back here, I have a removable decking plate that just bolts down. So that I can do maintenance, oil the bearings, or lubricate the bearings. If I need to take it apart to move it or whatever, it's easier with the roller out of there, because the roller is super heavy. So
That just makes it a little bit easier as well. But all in all, this is pretty much it. I still have to do the electronic side of it. I ordered the sensor needed to pick up the RPM signal off Amazon, so it will hopefully be here Tuesday, I think. And I already have the ARDyno board picked up off two-stroke stuffing. I still need to pick up an inductance clamp and for the bike RPM and a fan, like a squirrel cage fan, like a air mover fan, just so that I can have some cooling for radiators and stuff. But it's not bad for, again, just all mostly repurposed stuff, things that were left over from things and whatnot. So the only other step I can think of left really to do is to paint this thing. Probably just gonna paint it your typical trim clad dyno red. But so I think next episode, hopefully it'll be hooking up the electronics, doing a couple of test runs with it, and calibrating it and trying to get it going. Then I'll kind of give you a general idea how spinning a giant mass can give you horsepower. But I think that's it for me. Until next time, take care.